Thailand's Defense Technology Institute has signed a memorandum of understanding with the Royal Thai Army to develop a medium-range tactical unmanned aerial vehicle for the service's Army Aviation Center. The new unmanned aerial vehicle, called DIS-04, is expected to replace the Army's Searcher Mk2 unmanned aerial vehicle made by Israel Aerospace Industries, which have been in operation since the early 2000s. According to its 29 June announcement, Defense Technology Institute will partner with the Army to develop and test unmanned aerial vehicle prototypes, with production outsourced to private manufacturers when completed. The proposed DIS-04 design will be based on Chinese firm Bihangua's Sinine platform, which features a 7-meter-long twin-boom airframe with the engine positioned in the rear in a pusher propulsion configuration, slightly swept back wings that are about 14 meters in span, and a chin-mounted electro-optical sensor turret. Endurance is claimed to be up to 20 hours, although this will depend on whether the air vehicle is carrying its full payload capacity of 150 kilograms. AMR was the first to report that Bihang entered into an agreement with Defense Technology Institute in November 2018 aimed at cooperation in areas such as unmanned aerial vehicle research and development, production, and flight training. Representing Defense Technology Institute at the signing ceremony were top officials including General Manoran, Chairman of Defense Technology Institute Board of Directors, Priyacha Pradabmukh, General Manager of Defense Technology Institute, Fu Junhui, General Manager of Bihang UAS, and Xiao Janjiang, Deputy General Manager of Bihang UAS. The DIS-04 unmanned aerial vehicle is expected to be used by Army artillery regiments as airborne battlefield surveillance and targeting assets, a role presently filled by the Searcher Mk2 platforms. Defense Technology Institute previously delivered the DIS-02 mini unmanned aerial vehicle to the Royal Thai Marine Corps for trials in December 2020. The Institute also signed a separate memorandum of understanding with the Army for counter-unmanned aerial vehicle research and development in the same month. A prototype system was trialed in May 2021. Thanks for watching.